3-year grant, around $500,000, funded by the National Institute of Health. That grant came about through collaborations we had some ahead of the grant, but not around water pipe. So water pipe was definitely a new avenue for us. The goal there being we want to focus on the concept of toxicity, which toxicity actually has to have a chemistry and a biology aspect of it. You can't have just one without the other there. Water pipes are fascinating pieces of equipment in and of themselves, and they have a lot of variability in terms of their size, pipe height, hose length, hose type, what you put in it, the top of the head, how much water is in the bowl, lots of different things. So this call is coming out of the regulatory agency, the FDA is who regulates tobacco products. And so what is different than where we were 20, 30 years ago is the FDA is recognizing the need to look carefully at these products and to ask these kinds of questions.
We're one of only 9 labs that received this funding within the United States, and we're the only one that has undergraduates doing the actual research. The FDA has realized that the regulation that they passed back in 2009 was inadequate for this type of smoking because people weren't doing it. You don't regulate something that no one is doing. And so they recognized that hole in the legislation and didn't just say, okay, we're going to make a blanket statement. They said, we need evidence. So having the different pipes that can have different smoke that we knew ahead of time, but we hadn't gotten into the characterization, that's where the FDA is really interested in this from a regulatory science perspective. If you think about it, if you have a 3-foot-tall pipe that can support 4 hoses, that's likely to be being used in some sort of a social setting where that could be in a fraternity house on campus, it could be in a hookah cafe, but it's likely to be a much more social setting than if you have a small pipe that is under 12 inches tall and has 1 hose. That would be used by an individual person. Well, are there differences in not only the smoke, but how that smoke affects the lungs of the user? And so what we're interested in is not just having a knee-jerk reaction that says smoke bad, but saying this is what's happening, these are the differences, and we have evidence that supports this smoke is less bad, or this smoke is something that you really, really need to avoid in order to protect your own personal health. What we've been able to do with this almost $500,000 worth of funding is to buy a $100,000 piece of equipment. And within the past year and a half that we've had this grant, I've already had 15 separate students work with me from one semester or one summer to up to a year and working on an honors thesis. Some of the things that that allows our students to do is to get a taste of the research and to also really dig in and do something that can have impact far beyond the Davidson community.